Okay, they should be able to hear us now just fine.
Okay, I'm recording. Sorry about that. Having technical issues, time constraints, and miscommunication because he's in Central Time Zone. I'm on the East Coast.
Yeah, I want to thank Rich for letting me get up in the morning first. Well, I can't really say morning.
I drank way too much coffee like a crack addict last night, so I have like 4 hours of sleep in me, but that's all right. I'm used to it.
Yeah, I didn't get much sleep last night
Right,
because
we'll
I
wait
was.
4 minutes in case anyone else is. This is about, no, it's not about 3 kilobytes. A lot of people are thinking that, and I said this in the video, and he Blackbuster even backed me up. It isn't about 3 kilobytes. It's really, at the end of the day, about why we prefer what we prefer. I don't even know technically. Maybe there can be. I don't know. Maybe there could be a winner. There can't be a winner. I don't know. But what I'm really getting at with this is why consoles, in terms of sales, are winning, and why even hardcore gamers who aren't tech savvy tend to lean towards consoles. Now, for anyone here who didn't see
Just a
me talk
second. They're
about,
saying they can't hear you.
you can't hear me? Can you hear me now? Get naked if you can hear me.
Too quiet.
I can. Sound is fine.
I got the volume as loud as it can get, as far as like the
Fine, fine. I can
Ustream.
hear him. Call Verizon. Right, everyone says it sounds fine. One last time, roll call. Can you hear me? Okay. All right.
I'm turning it up a little bit, see if that'll help.
Okay. Sound is good. So let's start over again. The first thing I'm going to say is that I'm not in Black Bond. Listen to me. Blackbuster critic, we're not looking to sit here to crucify each other. We're not going to sit here starting calling each other names and all that shit because that's not a debate then. That's,
I know.
15-year-old female bullshit. And that's not what we're looking to do. Well, basically, what we're saying is that what we're going to do is state our cases. I had my diarrhea of the mouth last night in my video, so I'll let him start first. What I will say is this, and this is not me trying to pat myself on the back just so people know, I have a PC that I do game on. I will state my hardware, not looking for a badge of honor, just so people know that I can play current gen games so I understand what I'm talking about. AMD Phenom 2, 3.5 gigahertz, and I have a ATI Radeon 5830. So I can play current games, and I'm downloading freaking one from Steam right now as we speak.
Okay.
And Steam gives me a mild erection, so. So I'll let you have the post first, or the stand, or the soapbox, or whatever the hell you want to call it, and then we'll go from there.
What do you want me to talk about first?
State the case of why, PC gaming is superior for everybody.
It's cheaper.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. How is that?
You spend $300, $400 on a gaming PC, and all the money you save buying the PC games all comes back around. Like, Dead Rising 2, $39.99 on the PC, while on the consoles it's $59.99. And in other areas of the world, it's even more expensive than that, like in Australia.
Yeah, due to inflation. Agreed. But the thing about it is, what PC and what specifications are you talking about that you can get for about 300, 400 bucks? I'm asking out of interest. I'm not asking rhetorically.
Most games that come out today have recommended settings for GT, what, 8800s, and those were about 3 years ago. So even people with PCs even 4 years ago can still run these games. Even games like Crysis can run on single core CPUs.
I had a Pentium 4 hyper-threading, man, with a 6800 Ultra, and it ran but it was a slideshow. And that in 2005 was a high, it was a high-end HP PC. And I mean, dual cores, the first ones that came out were the Intel Pentiums, dual cores, and those came out in early 2006.
Just a second. HP.
Yeah, HP.
All right, go ahead.
H at the time, listen, hold on. HP 3 gigahertz Pentium 4 with hyper-threading. That was close to, if not the top, what you could get back in 05, okay? And a 6800 Ultra card, NVIDIA. And it, HPs have ASUS motherboards on them, and it had 2 gigs of RAM back then, which was a lot.
Yeah, and 2 gigs of RAM is basically all you really need for games of today as well. And this is 2005.
But it ran, I was getting like 15 frames a second on the lowest settings with Crysis. So I don't really know what, you know, you're not playing Crysis. You may be able to put the disc in and load it. You know, a lot of times when I look at the minimum settings on games, you know, now the minimum settings is the 8800 GT. And minimum settings, you well know and I know, is not, they say it's playable, but it's not.
Well,
And there's a lot of times that the minimum settings
that
when you play
depends
a
on the
game.
person. Some people can play at that. I wouldn't, but that can't go for everybody.
Dude, who would play a game playing when the game plays at like 20 frames per second? It looks like a slideshow.
On my
I
old
feel
PC, I
it's like
played at 20.
it's like watching porn on AOL with dial-up back in like 1996.
I'm just saying, you know, we can't speak for everybody. What's good for us might not be the same for them as far as frames per second.
And everyone out there, consoles, the games are always should run at a minimum. Sometimes they go right down to 28. The average frame rate for consoles is 30 frames per second.
Yeah, some PS3 games go down to 24 frames. That's pretty bad.
Well, Bayonetta is a perfect example of that. Yeah. Well, yeah, they 90. Okay, let me take that back then. 90% of games for consoles, if not higher, should run and do run at 30 frames per second. What's not true?
Yeah,
It's not a
Bayonetta.
trash port on the PS3. They patched it. It's still not as good as the 360 one, but that's not what we're here for.
Yeah,
So,
that's totally different.
yeah, we would be here till we if we start talking about all the nitpicking shit between all the hardware, we would be here till 6 a.m. Now, pretty much the other thing too is my biggest thing is this, okay? There's a lot of people I know personally in my life that if they jerk off to video games, like it's kind of almost creepy. And like I have a friend, Sean, last name will be out of it because I think some people here may know him. Call of Duty, Modern Warfare, for like 5 months, he played it 11 hours a day, okay?
Yeah,
And what happens is,
unfortunately.
now here's a game that on the PC is you could run it at native high definition resolutions, because if anyone out there doesn't know, on the consoles it's sub HD. They upscale it to 720p.
Yeah,
Okay?
sucks.
But because he doesn't want to, he's actually a technician too, because he doesn't want to deal with the BS that doesn't always happen, but does happen with PCs. And I have a story first, but then I'll shut up because I know I'm talking a lot right now. He plays it on a console. He bought it on a console. He would not buy it on the PC. I actually tried to convince him of it, and he said, "If you try to tell it, say it to me, I'll smack you across the head." That's the only one he got. You know, he has a 360. He has kind of, I guess you could say, he has a gaming PC, but he doesn't want to deal with it. And that's the thing, is that the general public,
What
and
do you mean
sometimes
by
even me, as a person who has a
what do you
PC,
mean by
yeah,
kinda has a gaming PC?
he has a 1 gig 8600 GT in there, and he has a quad core processor. But 8600 GT, you can't say is a. I mean, that was when I got it back in 07. That thing was a entry level card.
Well, the minimum system requirements for Modern Warfare 2 is 6600 DT.
Agreed. But he didn't want to deal with it. Well, here's the thing, Modern Warfare 2. The other thing about it too was the big deal was the servers. He didn't want to deal with that. You were going through the Steam servers, and a lot of people were pissed at that, and so was he.
Well, then use third-party servers.
But once again, though, man, you're saying extra things that people don't want to fucking deal with. Even people that are, you know, excuse my language, I'm out there, because I know people don't want me to swear. When you put a game in your 360, even the PS3, all right, a lot of people shit on the internet experience or the gaming experience on the PS3. I could give a crap about cross-game chat, but once again, we'll go into a whole other debate about that. You put the game in, and in most cases, at least from what I played, I don't have a problem with it. You know, I have pretty good luck on the PC too, but a lot of people don't want to think. That's the reason why consoles have always outdone most of the time. As of recently, I should say more so. In the past 5 to 7 years.
So consoles are for people who don't want to create their own experiences. Instead, they want to be lazy and just have what the corporations throw at them.
That's not... you can't say that, man.
You said people don't... You said people don't want to think. If he doesn't want to just use a third-party server, which all you have to do is basically copy and paste into a text file, all you have to do is Google it, third-party server, Modern Warfare PC. It's not difficult. It takes 2 seconds.
I understand that, but you have to understand... You know, even that, the people want to plug. It's not even that they want to get fed. They want the experience to be as smooth as possible. Let me give you an example outside of Modern Warfare.
Wait a minute. They want a smooth game, but they want to play a Modern Warfare game, a Call of Duty game on the consoles.
Yeah.
And they want to play online, and they want it to be smooth.
They want it to be smooth. Yeah. Not Black Ops. Now, Black Ops on the PS3 is having issues, but that's Treyarch. But...
There was issues on all the platforms.
I play Black Ops on the 360 all the time. It's fine.
There was issues all across the board. I've seen all the articles.
Maybe I haven't played it enough, but I have played quite a bit of it, and I haven't had a problem with it. But here is another example of... why PC gaming pisses me off. I have a love-hate relationship with it, and that was really the key to this debate. Now, you know, you worked in retail, and unfortunately I had a temporary job for the past few months where I worked in retail.
Yeah.
Opening up a game, any game, if you open up software, okay, you can't bring it back. If you open up a game and say, yeah, there's, you know, I don't like it, you'll get the shit slapped out of you by customer service there. That's just the way it goes. Because they don't want people pirating shit.
Yeah.
So I bought Batman Arkham Asylum. Okay. I had, back then I had XP, which is, who cares? It was a DirectX 9 game. DirectX 9, I think it was DirectX 10. I'm not sure. Whatever. There was a known issue with it when I went home, and there was no way around it, that you couldn't play Arkham Asylum because there was an issue with Windows Live with Windows XP. They let me bring it back because the issue was so known.